So I don't know if this video or my other Kenpachi video is going to be coming out first. The other one's just talking about Kenpachi with some inverse scaling. This is actually Kenpachi with some crossverse scaling because I find it's pretty interesting to do the character video and then actually pit them up against another character. It's like a fighting game video tutorial, like, oh, this is what the character does and everything, but then here's them in action. And this video in particular is pretty interesting. Kenpachi versus Hercules, when we get to the results and as we go through the video, you guys will see what I mean as we go through this, but you guys know how this goes, right? Like, we go over the strength, speed, and abilities. There's no reason for me to just dawdle on here at the beginning. Let's just get right into the video. Now, I went over Kenpachi's strength in his own video, but just to reiterate, we have Gremmy, who with his imagination can create these pocket realms that contain numerous stars, a galaxy, and what appears to be a nebula. Yet, when faced with Kenpachi, he couldn't imagine anything stronger than him, so Kenpachi should scale to be that high. However, let's say that Gremmy, for the sake of argument, was only able to make such an impressive pocket dimension because there was numerous clones of himself, and so he was able to make something that impressive. Yet when he was trying to imagine something stronger than Kenpachi, it was just his main body. Even if you don't have that, and even if you don't scale him to Yamamoto, who does scale to being at least multi-solar system as well, because his Bankai was going to destroy the Soul Society pretty casually by just merely existing, even if you don't scale him to either of those two, he could at least be planetary to at minimum multi-continental by scaling above Full Hollow Ichigo in the novel, where he fights Aroncar Sion Grants, who Uryu, who was present for the Ukiura and Ichigo fight, says that Sion Grants is on par with Full Hollow Ichigo. Full Hollow Ichigo in Hellverse threatens to destroy the realm of Hell. Hell can be anywhere from planetary just based on how many people need to be able to fit into it, or if you really want to stretch Kokuto's statements, and I really do mean you have to stretch his statements, you can get Hell to being universal in size. But let me reiterate, big asterisks everywhere, you do have to stretch his statements, but it is somewhat possible. But let's say you don't think Hellverse or the novel are canon, right? We can still fall back on the Espada scaling, where at the bare minimum, the Espada are destroying a country-sized structure in Las Noches. However, the actual amount of force that's needed to destroy Las Noches would be around multi-continental. Now, I'm not going any lower than that because you can't really argue against that. It's like, we have a pretty definitive size for Las Noches and we have calcs for it. I mean, even if you really wanted to fall back, you'd go back to the Soul Society where we have like mountain level calcs. And if you know anything about Fate Stay Night Hercules, being mountain level would be more than enough, but you know, Kenpachi's definitely not just mountain level. Now, we've gone over how the Mimehage and the Ashwallen are like millions of times the speed of light because they're traveling like dozens of solar systems in a few seconds, but maybe you don't think Kenpachi scales to any of those characters, right? Well, I'm about to open your eyes because Yuha's the one that grabs the Mimehage, so he reacts to that. And then Latanto is the one that reacts to the Ashwallen, and Yuha really only fights Ichigo, and Latanto gets bodied by Ichigo and then gets bodied by Yuha. But what if I told you that Ichigo bodying Latanto does scale back to Kenpachi? All right, listen here. So we have Ichigo beating all the Stern Ritter girls. He just absolutely bodies all of them. Then he goes up to the Soul Palace. Him and Grimmjow are pretty relative. They both get bodied by Asken, but Grimmjow fights Hikone. And do you want to know who else fights Hikone? Kenpachi. There you go. Kenpachi's like millions of times the speed of light. It's hilariously easy. As for his abilities, Kenpachi doesn't really have any abilities. He's just really durable. He has Kendo. He can two-swing his sword and make giant Excalibur-like Getsugatencho beams. But other than that, you can maybe say that Nozarashi's ability is to be able to cut anything, but it's not really gonna matter when it meshes with Heracles' ability, as we'll get into in a little bit. So basically, just treat Kenpachi like a giant beat stick with maybe an ability to cut anything he wants. Heracles is also pretty simple because he just blatantly has a statement of being able to shatter a mountain with just one swing of his club. I guess you could try to scale him to star level using Rin, where Rin at the very beginning of Fate Stay Night says, well, mages can create stars pretty casually with magic, but does Hercules actually scale to Rin's magic? I mean, she obliterated him with magic in one of the routes, although it doesn't show very well in the anime, I don't think. But even then, like, what, Hercules' durability would scale to star level at best? So it doesn't really scale back to him. I mean, sure, he is physically stronger than Rin. Like, I'm not contesting that, but he's not as strong as the magic Rin is talking about. Because even then, can we even prove the creation magic Rin is talking about is equivalent to her gem magic? Or is she just talking that, like, base magic can do that? It's very vague and open-ended. So mountain to star level doesn't really matter. Like, maybe star level durability, that's fine. I don't really care. Then we have his speed. There's some statements for them being light speed. There's some really atrocious statements for them being like the speed of sound and everything, so it could be very bad. There is a calc that has gone around where Iskandar dodges Excalibur, and it comes out to being like 42 times the speed of light or something like that. Basically nowhere near where Kenpachi is. And since we're using Fate Stay Night Hercules as like none of the immeasurable speed arguments, you can maybe make an irrelevant speed one, because we see Artoria and Emiya in the Throne of Heroes in the Fate Stay Night Unlimited Blade Works anime, and they're able to move around and do things in there. So that might give them irrelevant speed, but they don't actually like talk about the root and everything in there being like an outerversal space in that anime. So maybe it's not even that impressive. Then there's Hercules' skills, and he's just a little more complex than Kenpachi, right? He has Valor, which makes him immune to mental debuffs, but Kenpachi's not going to use anything like that anyway, so that doesn't matter. He has Precognition with Eye of the Mind, which I guess is useful, because in a slugfest like this, being able to predict your opponent would be nice, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. Battle Continuation makes Hercules just a bit harder to kill, although for him it doesn't really seem to matter, because everyone hacks him apart and kills him pretty casually. He has two Noble Phantasms. One of them is 9 lives, which is basically 9 consecutive strikes meant to neg the Hydra's regeneration, and it will just obliterate whoever you throw it at, but, well, we'll talk about that in a little bit as well, won't we? Finally, there's God Hand, the really only thing that's keeping Hercules alive in this match. It negates attacks of a certain level. Basically, you have to be B+ and above to be able to bypass God Hand, and it also gives him 12 additional lives. He has a life for each labor that he completed while he was alive, but the only thing that's really going to save him here is not even just the B+ and above thing. It's that this is actually a conceptual defense, meaning you have to have some like way to attack at a conceptual level to bypass the God Hand. So basically what we have right here is a stalemate. Kenpachi is way too fast and way too strong for Hercules to deal with, but because Hercules has a conceptual defense that protects him from all attacks, and Kenpachi, while he does maybe have the ability to cut anything, we don't know if it's at a conceptual level, so we can't say for certain if he'd actually be able to cut through Hercules's God Hand. What this means is basically Kenpachi would be zipping around the battlefield, just hacking away at Hercules, being like, there's nothing I can't cut, while Hercules is just getting swatted around the battlefield. And sure, he does have Precognition, but I don't think there's any feats for the Precog in Fate where someone reacted to someone millions of times faster than, like, actually millions of times faster than them. So Hercules would just get swatted around for a long time until one of them either got bored and left, or one of them just died because it took so long. Like, this fight could literally go on for like years upon years, because Kenpachi's a Shinigami. They can live for well over 1,000 years, and Hercules, it kind of just depends on who he was summoned by. Was he summoned by Ilya? Because eventually she's gonna run out of mana and then he's gonna disappear. Was he summoned by the world? Because if he was summoned by the world, he can last a good bit longer, but he's not going to last there forever. So really, it does come down to a stalemate where maybe Kenpachi does win in the end, because Hercules would eventually disappear. But then it begs the question of, why did I even do this matchup, right? Why do a stalemate for a Kenpachi's versus thing? Well, this whole video, the point is that while I do really like Fate, and it's a very powerful series, it kind of overshadows Bleach and just how OP they are. They're way stronger, they're way faster, their abilities are insane, but Bleach characters can still hold their own, and they can force a W in some scenarios. Because we did Gilgamesh versus Aizen, and Gilgamesh just completely doo-doo cock it all over Aizen. But in this one, Hercules is basically hopeless against Kenpachi. The only thing that's keeping him alive is this defense that he got. And in the future, if we find that Kenpachi does have an ability to cut all things, and it does hit at a conceptual level, or even if Kenpachi just cuts a conceptual attack or a conceptual being in Bleach in the future, then at that point, he would literally just dice up Hercules and kill him and then move on with his day. So that's the whole point of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed though. I'm gonna go ahead and get out of here. All my links are in the description, but with that being said, you guys have yourselves a nice day, and make sure you drink your water.
Come on, let's fight!